My name is Andrew Beck. We're at Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center in Boston, Massachusetts. And my position here is I'm director of bioinformatics at the Cancer Research Institute. So I direct a research lab, and we're focused on the study of cancer in human patients. And our real goal is to try to develop and apply tools in bioinformatics to better understand the molecular factors that are causing the cancers. And then to use that knowledge to develop improved methods for diagnosing cancer, for better evaluating pre-malignant changes that happen in tissue, and then ultimately to lead to better both preventative treatments and treatments for patients who already have cancer. My mother's a dermatologist and a dermatopathologist, and my father was an ophthalmologist, and he runs an institute in Tampa that is a data coordinating center for big randomized clinical trials. So I actually studied history as an undergraduate in college, and then I went to medical school, and I thought I was going to be a practicing physician, but I really started enjoying pathology, which is kind of the study of how diseases develop and how we classify different disease processes. And then I also started studying bioinformatics and computational methods while I was in medical school. And then after that, I did residency in pathology to really learn sort of the tools and methods that people are using in the clinic for diagnosing disease. So it's kind of a mix of pathology and computation, my training. So it's a really exciting time to be doing bioinformatics in cancer because there's been an explosion of really great technologies over the past few years for extracting lots of data out of patient tissue samples. The overriding thing is wanting to make a difference for patients. I think one thing that I like about medical research is that that can be sort of the big overriding motivator. But before what we do might actually impact a patient directly in a meaningful way, it might take 5 years. So it's hard on a day-to-day basis for that to motivate you. So it's other things just like developing computational methods for examining changes in the DNA in a tumor or in a patient's normal sample. We have new technologies for measuring protein expression. We can measure that at a single cell level and quantitate where in the cell and where in the cancer specific proteins are being expressed. And then all these things sort of come together in the morphology of tumor cells and normal cells and the way they interact. And what physicians are currently using to make diagnoses are unable to integrate all these different data types and are in general not quantitative. So the way it would impact patients is if someone, for example, undergoes a breast biopsy, and people are using these tools that are able to provide very quantitative, reproducible diagnoses, that they can be highly confident that they're getting, you know, the right diagnosis, it's accurate, reproducible, and can really be used to guide the right treatment. Whereas if this technology didn't exist, you know, maybe some percentage of the time they'd get the wrong diagnosis and the wrong treatment. There's a feeling of satisfaction for, you know, a job well done and making a small incremental step towards that goal that I think makes it, you know, really motivating to do on a day-to-day basis. So that's really what would be my goal, is to really see that through.